Welcome to a new episode of my High Performance Java Persistence video course. In this episode, we are going to talk about mapping the many-to-many table relationship when using JPA and Hibernate. Just like the one-to-one relationship, the many-to-many association can be either unidirectional or bidirectional. While adding elements to a many-to-many JPA association does not depend on the underlying Java collection type, when removing elements, the many-to-many JPA relationship behaves just like a unidirectional one-to-many association. The many-to-many JPA association hides the join table from the application developer. However, if you want to map additional columns of the underlying join table, you have to map the intermediary table as a JPA entity. We are going to see how to map the join table and, therefore, replace the many-to-many JPA association with two bidirectional one-to-many JPA relationships. The many-to-many JPA association maps a many-to-many database table relationship. In a many-to-many relationship, there are two parents and one child. Both the post and the tag tables are parents, since they are independent entities whose life cycles are not dependent on any other entity. On the other hand, the post tag table is the child in this many-to-many table relationship, and it defines if a given post table record is associated with a row in the tag table. Just like it was the case with other JPA associations, the many-to-many relationship can be either unidirectional or bidirectional. In a unidirectional many-to-many association, only one side maps this JPA relationship. For instance, in this class diagram, the post entity has a collection of tag entities. The tag entity does not map this relationship, hence the many-to-many association is unidirectional. In the post entity, the mapping is done as follows. The many-to-many annotation is placed on the collection of tag entities, and the join table allows you to provide the name of the join table as well as the two foreign key columns which build the many-to-many table relationship. The join column attribute is for the foreign key linking to the post entity, while the inverse join column attribute is for the other side of the many-to-many table relationship. Note that the cascade attribute includes the persist and merge entity state transitions only. This is because cascading the remove operation will affect both the intermediary table and the other end as well. However, in a many-to-many table relationship, both ends are independent, playing the parent side role, the child side being represented by the intermediary join table. Cascading makes sense only from the parent side to the child, and that's done automatically by Hibernate when associating or dissociating an entry in the many-to-many Java collection. That's why orphan removal and cascade type remove are not desirable for many-to-many associations. For a bidirectional many-to-many association, the effect would be catastrophic if both parent sides are set to cascade the entity removal operation. That's because the cascade will bounce back and forth between the two parent sides, practically deleting every entity that happens to be associated on the other side. So, if all entities from one side are associated with all entities on the other side, cascading the remove operation in a bidirectional many-to-many association will delete everything on both sides. In a bidirectional many-to-many association, not only the post entity maps the collection of tags, but the tag entity also maps the associated post entities. Therefore, you can navigate the many-to-many association in both directions. Mapping the bidirectional many-to-many association requires adding the many-to-many annotation on both ends. For the post entity, the mapping is identical to the unidirectional many-to-many association example we have previously seen. However, unlike the unidirectional many-to-many association, this time the tag entity maps the associated post entities using the many-to-many annotation and with the mapped by attribute set. Just like it was the case for the one-to-many and one-to-one relationships, because only one side can control the bidirectional association, one end will use the mapped by attribute to indicate that this particular side is to be skipped when synchronizing the state of the JPA entities with the relational database. Like every bidirectional JPA association, providing the utility methods for adding and removing elements is good practice, and the many-to-many relationship is no different. Now, let's consider that we create two post and two tag entities. We are going to associate the first post entity with both tags and the second post entity with the first tag only. because the tax property in the post entity cascades the persist and merge entity state transitions, we only need to persist the post entities, and the tag entities will be persisted as well. When running this code example, Hibernate is going to execute the following SQL insert statements. As expected, two post and two tag rows have been added, as well as three join table records that hold the relationship between posts and tags. While adding elements yields the expected SQL statements, removing elements is trickier because it depends on the underlying Java collection type. Considering that the many-to-many association is mapped using a Java util list, where removing a tag entity reference from the tags property in the post entity, Hibernate will remove all post tag records associated with this particular post entity and re-add back the remaining post tag records that were not deleted. This is exactly how unidirectional one-to-many bag works in Hibernate. However, for the many-to-many JPA association, this behavior is identical whether the association is unidirectional or bidirectional. As long as we use a Java util list with the many-to-many JPA annotation, the collection is going to behave like a typical unidirectional Hibernate bag, which is not very efficient. On the other hand, if we use a Java util set and remove the tag entity from the tags collection in the post entity, Hibernate is going to issue a single delete statement. So, for a many-to-many JPA association, sets are a much better alternative to lists. The last thing on the agenda is about mapping the join table as a JPA entity. The entity relationship diagram changes to accommodate the post-tag child entity, and both the post and tag entities are going to map a collection of post-tag entities this time. The post-tag entity mapping looks as follows. The post and the tag many-to-one associations use the MapsID JPA annotation, which tells Hibernate that the underlying foreign key column is controlled by the post-tag entity identifier. In this case, the post property is controlled by the post-ID property in the post-tag ID embedded identifier, while the tag property is controlled by the tag ID property in post tag ID. The post tag ID embeddable type contains the post ID and tag ID properties that build up the compound entity identifier. Using an embeddable type is the most common way of mapping a compound identifier when using JPA and Hibernate. Now, the post and tag entities will no longer use the many-to-many JPA annotation. Instead, the relationship is mapped as a bidirectional one-to-many JPA association. Notice the use of the mapped by attribute, which tells Hibernate that the many-to-one side on the post tag entity is in charge of controlling the JPA association. So, this time, the post entity will no longer contain a collection of tag entities, but a collection of post tags. The same goes for the tag entity. Unlike a many-to-many JPA association, we can now use cascade type all, since the cascade operation goes to the post-tag child entity and not to the other parent entity. The same is true for the orphan removal attribute. Since this relationship is now formed out of two bidirectional one-to-many associations, the use of add and remove utility methods is highly recommended. However, implementing the remove tag method is not as trivial as a typical one-to-many parent-child association. That's because, this time, we need to synchronize two collections and two many-to-one associations. In spite of the increased mapping complexity, mapping the many-to-many join table has its benefits. When removing a post-tag element, Hibernate is going to issue just one delete statement, which removes the associated record from the join table. So, apart from allowing us to map extra columns that might be contained in the underlying join table, in case you are using a Java util list, performance is much better than when using the many-to-many JPA annotation.